the player with foot in opponent's mouth disease, Carl Perfect Legend White.
Real quick, my comprehensive fight game strategy guidebook, Game Fuwei of the Digital Fist, is now available in paperback. When you're ready to take your game to the next level for the new era, the link is in the description. Now let's get into the video. So I've been practicing a lot of Devil Gen. Can I say more why I chose? All right, so when I first got into competitive Tekken, I was playing with like Law and Fang and stuff. But I started seeing how like Devil Gen moved and then I also started seeing all the Mishimas from Tekken Tag and how they played. And I saw that being emulated with Tekken 5 Devil Gen with the players at the time. And I was like, man, that looks really fun to play with. And I would really like the Electric Wing Godfist and just the idea behind it, the execution and stuff. So I was like, all right, I'm about to play with this. It was the most fun I have when I play the game. So that's why. So it was like a lot of studying past matches of different players throughout the years, and then like seeing players at the current time and studying them, and then teaching myself how to do Electric Wing Godfist like just from scratch, and like movement and everything, and just getting better over time. But he's really fun. People, in my opinion, I hear them talk about his strength levels and stuff and his generic moves and everything. I still think he's good. I in my mind, I don't even think he needs buffs or nothing. I mean, I say buff Devil Gen, but that's just because, you know, I ain't gonna complain my character gets buffs. But yeah, like I think he's really good at controlling space and playing keep out and also maximizing heavily on his big damage. And then if he needs to make a comeback, he always has Hell Sweep as a threat. He's got good mids, and his Power Crush I think is pretty good for setting up his stuff. And his new moves like Morning Crow 1, Morning Crow 2 are really good, especially in this game where running attacks, they have buffed them and now they're like kind of nerfing them, like Dragon Offs and Azuzena, their plus frames. Well, his Morning Crow 1 acts like a running attack and it still has plus 8 frames on it on block, and it's does chip and leaves you point blank range, so you can set them up with a like basically not a way mix up, but it's like you got your three command grabs, the 1-2, the 1+2, overhead low. Yeah, I don't see anyone use up four. His up 4-1 is really good as well. Like you land that, Mortar Crawl 2 is a natural combo, and it's a heat engager. And then like when you start looking for that move, then and start ducking, then 4-4-4 can hit you. It's a while standing 2 can hit you. Running 3 can hit you. Of course, you know, Morning Crow 1 can hit you. But Morning Crow 2 as well, which is basically the faster version of Morning Crow 1 and the version that you can't sidestep. And then you can get hit by that. He can gauge off that and also combo off that if he's heat engaged. So it's like Devil Gen makes you feel like you don't want to move. Like he makes you feel like you don't want to sidestep. You don't want to duck. You don't want to stand still. I mean, that's also like, you know, that's not moving, but still, like he makes you, it's a big mental stack basically. He feels like, what should I be doing right now? And he does a lot of damage, good wall carry. He's got good way to close out and stuff. I think other characters, people might find them easier. I still think Devil Gen is the most well-rounded Mishima. Like he can attack you from distances most people can't. He has a better running 3 type move for pressure. Then he's got like back 1+2, which is really good. Mid, counter hit knockdown, and chip damage move. And then he's getting the laser scraper buffs. But yeah, I play him because generally, Devil Gen usually is pretty well rounded and can fight everybody as long as you know how to play the game. And I don't know, I love the sound he makes when he does Electric Wing Godfist. He's like, duh, that's my shit. That was just pretty fun. He's basically Tekken 3 Gen. I messed him up. But yeah, he's Tekken 3 Gen. He's still doing Laser Scraper. He's still doing 4-4-2, Electric Wing Godfist, Wave Dash, Insta Wild Standing 2, Hell Sweeps. But now he's doing grabs. He's got up 4-1. So Delgin still maintains his strong legacy strategies too, on top of the new stuff he's got. But the little changes in his kit, like down 4-1, 2, not being a mid-mid anymore, is mid-high. It's kind of weird, because then you do like down 4-1. So this is what I do to cover that. When I do down 4-1, I'll do down 4-1, and then I'll do down 4-1 again, because they might duck to try to challenge the high. Or you do down 4-1 and say they do like a immediate move, then you do down 4-1 into down 1 and you power crush them. It's like different stuff you can do. Or you just do down 4-1 and nothing to see what they choose to do. As the competition begins to grow, where can we catch me dominate with Devilgen? Well, on my stream, mostly. Outside of at tournaments, the majors I've been showing up to, maybe some locals and regionals. Yeah, it'll be mainly on my stream or on YouTube, my YouTube. And I've been playing on Tampa Never Sleeps' tournament series like almost weekly. I didn't play this week because I'm just waiting for the patch to come out now. But yeah, after it does, I'll be interning again. I saw I was on a tier list, actually. Also, Speed Kicks is really good too. People can't downplay that, his ability as well. But Still, people shouldn't be losing to his day two Alyssa. That's pretty bad. But he could also be lying about it being his day two Alyssa and just saying that to sound good, you know what I'm saying? But here's a tier list that I'm on, the carry list. This is made by Inconsiderate Raccoon. Excuse the, I guess, the little chat bubble that's on there. I took a screenshot from his stream, but it says, if you're high on this list, you are beyond carry. So, what, Harada's Vision will be the highest. You got Fury X, Guttle, Super TF, Afro Senju, Sonic Fox, Six Arakan, regular size Majin, Ume, Big Nose, and then Shinblade. It was say All Hand. What does it say? I can't understand. Or AJ Hand. Let's see. Carry since Tekken 7. Shinzo, Learn Burn Neck, FDX, Booster Blast, and then S tier carry would be Lion. Was it Lion Cock? What does it say? I don't know. Leffen, Sophie, Strider Fury, Yin Crescent, Warning, Ice Spam, Poke Chop. Damn, they're S tier carry. And then A tier carry is Lucari, JJ Breeze, Raccoon himself, me, Majin Obama, Janver, Cadence, Brawl Pro, Kaiser, Chikurin, Trigger J. So I'm on the same tier list as the Evo champion, the Evo Japan champion. On the same tier, so not complaining. And then of course we got Trizzy, Tone, Mac, King Ray Jr., Triple A, Since Sonic, Momo Dog. Then B tier is Ninja Killer, Run It Black, Joka, Enoch, Jasandy, Yukio, Jake Man, and Joey Fury. I don't know what the one is right here under Brawl Pro. And then C tier is Envanes, Glaciating, Speed Kicks, Anakin, Arslan, Ash, Kane, Hayes, Lil Majin, Knee, Joe Crush, Fighting GM, JDCR, Shadow, Sephi Black, Cuddlecore, Qdons. And then I don't know yet. I'm Real Feels, Tendo, Super Akuma, Noel Strife, K-Wiz, MYK, TMM, is that the main man? A.O. Richie, Jod, and Bansef. But yeah, the higher you are, the more carried you are. The lower you are, the less carried you are. But yeah. Yeah, I'm carried, y'all, apparently. Oh well. I told y'all, Heat Smash and Electric Wing Office. Carried by Fundamentals. Yep, I'm carried by Hell Sweep.